हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट इलेक्ट्रोस्पिरलाइजेशन और ESI अंडर मास स्पेक्ट्रोस्कोपी. सो व्हाट इज ESI? इट इज अ टाइप ऑफ इवेपोरेटिव आयनाइजेशन टेक्निक व्हिच इज यूज्ड टू एनालाइज द हाई मॉलिक्यूलर वेट बायोमॉलिक्यूल्स लेबाइल एंड नॉन वोलेटाइल कंपाउंड्स. So, electrospray ionization is a type of evaporative ionization technique and it is used to determine the high molecular weight biomolecules, labile and non-volatile compounds. And due to these characteristics of ESI, mass spectroscopy is very popular and ESI is generally coupled with chromatographic instrument. Now coming to the methodology of electrospray ionization. So before studying methodology of electrospray ionization, first I will draw a block diagram for better understanding of this topic. So this is the block diagram of ESI instrument. Here one capillary will be present and through this capillary sample will be injected, and at the tip of the capillary high voltage will be supplied. So due to that high voltage potential, our sample will come through this capillary and it will be sprayed. Due to presence of this nebulizing gas, it will come from here and it will convert in the form of droplets and it will be ionized, and the ionization takes place due to this high voltage potential. So this sample will come through the ESI capillary, and due to presence of this nebulizing gas, this sample will be converted into the sprayed droplets like this. So this spray is produced due to this nebulizing gas, and here we are supplying power. So due to this power supply, here high voltage potential will be generated at the tip of this capillary. So due to that high voltage potential, these droplets will be ionized like this. So in next step, these droplets will come to the ionization chamber, and this ionization chamber is operated at normal atmospheric pressure. And in this ionization chamber, we are supplying heated dissolution gas, that is heated nitrogen gas. And due to that heated nitrogen gas, temperature up, this aeration chamber will be high and that will remove the solvent from the analyte and it will convert in the form of molecular ion. For example, if we are having the molecule M and this molecule M is surrounded by the solvent like this and this solvent is ionized like H+. Now due to this heated dissolution gas, dissolution takes place, means evaporation of this solvent takes place and it will convert in the form of MH+ like this. Now this molecular ion or quasi molecular ion will go further towards the ion acceleration chamber and ultimately it will go to the mass analyzer. From here we are supplying power and the positive side is attached with capillary and negative side will be attached with ion acceleration chamber and it will produce negative potential and that negative potential will help these positive ions to get the velocity and ultimately it will go towards the mass analyzer. Characteristic of this ASI technique is that it can also produce the multiply charged ions along with the singly charged ions. This electrospray ionization technique is used to ionize proteins, peptides, lipids, oligosaccharides, oligonucleotides, synthetic polymers, etc. So this is the complete details about electro spray ionization. In my next video, I will discuss about APCI. Thank you.